Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome back to DVD and Blu-ray updates. Now, unfortunately, today I don't have any Blu-rays to add to my collection, but I do have a number of DVDs, some older films, and some that are not so old. But I made these purchases at various locations, including Big Lots, a few from the pawn shop, and a few from Blockbuster Video. But before I begin, guys, I have a little interesting story to tell you guys. Now, you remember, firstly, from my last DVD and Blu-ray update where I discussed how I was getting a thumbs down. Well, a few days after I made that video, I decided to make a vlog. So I recorded the vlog and all. You know, I had no intentions of talking about the person giving me the thumbs down. But it reared its ugly head, and I got a little bit angry during the making of the video. And I was going to post it, then I decided not to, because it turned into more of a rant. And not that I don't have anything against rant videos, it's just that a little voice in the back of my head said, don't feed the trolls. So I decided to leave the video on my hard drive. But since that time, I thought, well, it might be interesting for you guys to see just a little bit of that rant. So I'm going to show you guys just a little bit of that rant, and you can decide for yourself if you think it's a little bit over the top. So here's that rant from about a week ago that's never been seen by anybody. Let's take a look. You'll remember if you've seen the last one where I talked about the person that's giving me a thumbs down. Well, I'm still getting that. And I got to tell you guys, ever since I made that video where I mentioned the person giving me thumbs down, I've gotten more thumbs down on videos that they didn't do. But I just want to take this opportunity to say that if you're the one giving me thumbs down and you're watching, well, let me give you a finger. Fuck you. I don't give a shit. Fuck you. I think you're a fucking dumbass fuck that needs a life. That's what I think. Give me all the thumb down you like. I don't give a shit. But I think you're just a dumb motherfucking fuck. Get a life, you piece of shit. What do you think, guys? Was it worth it? Should I put the whole thing on YouTube? Let me know what you think. If you think it's indeed a case of feeding the trolls, then, you know, that's why initially I didn't put it on. But if you think it's a good idea to go ahead and see the entire rant in its entirety, let me know what you think. But anyway, since that time, guys, I was talking to a friend on YouTube. And as you guys know, I never reveal names or put anybody under the spotlight. But I was talking to one YouTube friend, and he was in a situation where he subscribed to a really popular YouTuber. And by popular, I mean the guy has upwards into 5,000 subscribers. And he really liked the guy. The guy's in the movie reviews, DVD updates, things like that, collection videos. So he asked the guy, asked the guy if he would want to do a joint video with him. And the response from the YouTuber that has 5,000 subscribers told him, come back when you get 1,000 more subscribers. And he was telling me about that, you know, and he has about 500 subscribers. And I thought, what a piece of shit. You know, it's really kind of irritating to me that people on YouTube who have a lot of subscribers somehow categorize other subscribers into smaller groups, or they don't want to touch these or have anything to do with these other subscribers because they don't have as many subscribers as they do. I thought it was really a shitty kind of response. And I've seen it before on YouTube where you have a guy that has 5,000, 8,000, 10,000 subscribers, and they're really shitty to other YouTubers that make videos that just put just as much harder work or put just as much time in their videos as they do. And yeah, they don't have as many subscribers, but they get shit on by the so-called YouTube celebrities. And I just think that's kind of shitty, you know. Come back when you have 1,000 more subscribers. It's like, oh, you don't have enough subscribers, so I don't want to have anything to do with you. So I thought that was really kind of a shitty attitude to have. And it just kind of made me think, you know, my goodness. You're doing the same thing I'm doing. Yeah, you have more subscribers. But don't forget where you came from. It's not all about subscribers. It's about, at least for me, it's about a hobby. It's about expressing myself. It's about doing something I enjoy. And I'm no better than anybody else here on YouTube. And I don't care if you have 1 million subscribers, you have 1 million views on your video. I don't give you the right, you know, to be insulting, to treat people like they're beneath you. And I just thought it was just totally wrong for this guy to tell him that. And you guys know what I'm talking about. You know the subscribers that, you know, that are so popular or have so many subscribers that they think they're celebrities or that they think they're famous. And you know, it's just BS. It's BS, you know. When it comes down to it, I think most people are here to just have fun. And if you're not, if you do think that you're a major Hollywood actor, something's wrong. Because when you fall outside that box to where you think it's not just a fun thing, or that your name is beyond deletion, or that your account can't be suspended, then there's a problem, because you really wouldn't be where you are if it was not for these little subscribers. Anyway, guys, that's my rant for the week. I just, it just moved me the wrong way when the guy told me, oh, you know, come back. You know, you don't have enough subscribers for me to talk to. I'm not interested. Just really, really a shitty thing to do, you know, just shitty. But anyway, we're going to start out with some films here, guys, that I think these first ones came from the pawn shop. And I probably wouldn't have found them anywhere else. All for a buck when I bought them, all in good condition. And some films that I didn't have, of course, and some films that I've actually never seen a couple of these. Or actually more than a couple. But the first one is a George A. Romero film. I've heard a lot about the film, kind of vaguely familiar with it, but like I said, I haven't seen it. And that movie is Monkey Shine. Now, I don't know if you guys have seen this, but the ones of you that have, let me know what you think. Is it a good film? I read the back. Sounds interesting. Definitely going to give it a look. And for George A. Romero's namesake, that's definitely worth a watch. The next one is another classic horror film that I had actually never seen. It's been remade, and the remake kind of received mixed reviews from fans. Some liked it, some didn't. I saw the remake, made me want to watch the original, and that is The Last House on the Left. Now, of course, this is a Wes Craven film, and I remember seeing the remake. I actually remember reviewing it in snapshots. Now, if you don't know what snapshots are, those were shorter reviews. For the most part, the remake was just alright. I really didn't care about the rape scene. Kind of ruined the film for me. Distasteful. Just okay. Hopefully this one is a little bit better. Next, now these are some films that I don't really expect to be very good. I kind of bought these movies just to finish my collection. And I had Universal Soldier, the original film, and I had Universal Soldier, I believe it's called Regeneration, but I never had 2 and 3, and I came across this double set, Universal Soldier 2 and 3, And like I said, I never saw the films. And what's kind of funny is this cover has Burt Reynolds on it. I just don't picture Burt Reynolds in a Universal Soldiers movie. But like I said, I don't expect these to be very good. It's more of a completist kind of thing. Okay, the next one is a film that I'd never heard of. A low-budget sci-fi film starring Mark Hamill. Now, for the most part, all the films that Mark Hamill did post-Star Wars were really bad. But $1, interesting premise on the back. Not expecting a whole lot, but thought I'd give it a look. And that is this film here, Laserhawk. Now, what I will say about this film is that originally, when I bought it, it came in a slim case. But I hate slim cases, so I just took the cover out and put it on a big case. And at first, I was thinking it's not really going to fit right. But to my surprise, it fit pretty good. You know, good enough to fit in this regular cover here. But I'm going to give it a look. I'm so behind on watching movies, guys, really. The next three are, and I know you guys are probably going to be shocked with this fact, are three films, and so far all these are came from the pawn shop, but these are three films that I have seen. As a matter of fact, I haven't seen the third one. Never seen the third film in this series, but I have seen one and two. Never had them in my collection, and that's probably going to shock you guys, because the films are the Beverly Hills Cops franchise. Now, this is part one, of course. Part two, and finally part three. I never saw part three. And what's interesting about these movies is that I saw the original in the theater, saw the second one in the theater, but just from word of mouth about the third one, I didn't really want to see it, and I'm really still not interested in seeing it. It's kind of sad, you know, that these obviously came from somebody's collection. And they pawned them and lost them. Now, I don't know, maybe they decided to upgrade to Blu-ray. But I don't even think, are these even out on Blu-ray yet? I don't think the, if anything, maybe the first one, but the second and third. And as a matter of fact, I don't think any of them are out on DVD or Blu-ray. But it's kind of sad to think that someone actually had these in their collection and had to get rid of them. Let's see. The last one from the pawn shop is a film series, again, where I had part one and two, and part three was there, so I decided to get it to complete my collection, and that is Final Destination 3. Now, I know that there's a 4 out now, and I've seen 4. I don't have it. I'd probably get it to complete my collection, but it's not a film that I just want badly. But this is pretty nice for a buck. It's a two-disc version. And I actually did see this one at the theater. I kind of like the Final Destination films because of the premise. Now, of course, none of them have been as good as part one and two. And progressively, the series has gotten worse and worse. But and the fourth one wasn't really nothing special. Next, we have some Big Lot buys. And I'm trying to keep all the certain ones together. This one came from Big Lot. I think there's two here that came from Big Lots. And this is one that I'd seen partially. It's based on the Star Trek phenomenon. And it's Trekkies. And I saw part of this, liked what I saw. Thought some of it was really interesting, some really humorous. And looking at the back of this, you see the lady here in the Starfleet uniform. Now, I remember that story from the news before I even saw the film. Apparently, she was doing jury duty, and she wore a Starfleet uniform to jury duty every day. As much as I love Star Trek, that ain't gonna happen. But $3 there, guys. And the next one is from Big Lots, and it's a film that I actually never saw. I remember when it was released. Got quite a bit of critical praise, and that movie is Greystroke, The Legend of Tarzan. And I'm interested in the film, like Tarzan. Remember, this film got quite a few accolades. Definitely want to give it a shot. Well, that's my Big Lots buys, guys and girls. What's next is, I think these came from Blockbuster. The next two came from Blockbuster. And then I got some I actually ordered from Amazon.com from a few of the buyers there. And then I have some from Target. Yeah, these are from everywhere. But this next movie is a film that I saw originally on Animal Planet. You guys may not know, but I'm really into animal documentaries, nature shows. Love dinosaur documentaries. But this was a film that I saw based on the life of a man named Timothy Treadwell. And he had a love for grizzly bears. And he, every year, for so many years, went to Alaska to live amongst the bears. And I won't go any further than that, guys, because if you ever see this, it'll ruin the story for you. But this is just an excellent film. Timothy Treadwell was definitely a different type of person, bordering on insanity. And to go live amongst grizzly bears in the wild, unarmed, no weapons, is definitely something that most people wouldn't do. I mean, if I love grizzly bears and I wanted to study grizzly bears, I'm not going to go there without some form of weapon. Now, I wouldn't want to kill the animals, but I'm going to take something. But Treadwell didn't take anything. And oftentimes in the video, which is the movie's made up of video footage that he filmed himself. And that's when it's really interesting. You're not seeing any acting. You're not seeing any nature scenes set up. You're seeing actual footage that he filmed himself. And he's just an interesting character. And from watching the film, I don't know if I felt pity for the guy, sympathy for the guy, anger towards the guy. Because, you know, you have this situation where you feel like he put himself into this situation. And then you think, well, you know, if it happens, it happens. If he gets attacked, he gets attacked. He shouldn't have been there. But then you think, well, maybe this guy don't have it all. And you feel a little bit of sympathy for him. But it's definitely a film that is multi-layered. I really liked it. One of the most interesting documentaries that I've ever seen. Definitely would tell you, if you're into animal nature pictures, check out this film. Now, this is Grizzly Man. And the one time that I caught it on Animal Planet, I definitely wanted to see it again. Nothing but accolades for the film. A tragic movie. Just a movie that... It's definitely a movie experience, and I would even recommend it to the casual viewer. Just, you know, just following the life of this man. It's just a very interesting life he lived. I don't know why, guys, my mouth is so dry today. Okay, this is one that also came from Blockbuster. It's one that I never saw, and I heard more about it when the sequel was released. Actually, I didn't even know anything about the film, but, you know, I saw it at Blockbuster. And these were not $9.99, guys. They were $4 for $20. If you bought it by itself, it's $9.99. But this is Hatchet. Now, from what I've seen on YouTube, there's several mixed views about this film, mixed opinions. Haven't seen it yet, but looking forward to watching it. I think my girl seen it and she liked it, but I haven't given it a look yet, but I definitely am. Next, this is one I ordered off Amazon, and I've always liked the film, never got a decent copy of it. I believe the film is in the public domain, so there's been a lot of shitty releases of it, and from doing a little bit of research, I found that this was the best copy that there was out there, at least from what I've read, and hopefully it's the truth. But this is Vincent Price in one of his classic films, The Last Man on Earth. Now, of course, this is based upon Richard Matheson's story, I Am Legend. And this film is considered to be the most like the novel. Though it isn't exactly like the novel, it is the most like it. And you know, you have big deviations in the other films that are based upon that book. Charlton Heston's The Omega Man deviated quite a bit. Even the newer film, I Am Legend, with Will Smith, deviated from the novel. And I like the film. What's interesting about the movie is that, you know, the film, the book takes place in America. Now, this film was actually filmed in Italy. And they kind of did it mockingly. They never revealed that it was filmed in Italy. They kind of just made you believe that it was being filmed in an American town. But The Last Man on Earth. And this will be actually the first time I've ever seen it in widescreen. I've seen some full screen shitty releases of the movie, and I might even have a couple, but hopefully this one is a vastly superior one. Now, here's one that I thought was really interesting. I've watched many documentaries on Jack the Ripper and found that he was an interesting character. Of course, I don't condone his behavior, but this is a film that I'd never heard of, and that's one good thing about my buddy Rambo, Rap for Life. He reviews a lot of films that the casual viewer would have never heard of. Films that fall on the wayside, so to speak, despite the fact that some of them are highly entertaining. That's why you need to listen to us guys. We know our shit. But anyway, the film is Jack's Back. And from what I've heard from Matt's review, this is more or less a copycat killer is copying the original Jack the Ripper's murders and beginning anew. And like I said, I like the concept. Sounds like an interesting movie. I like James Spader, and I'm definitely going to give this one a look. I don't believe this is available in the U.S. It's never been released here. This is a release that I got in the U.K., a Region 2 release. And though a lot of films may not be available in the U.S., check Amazon.com, which I believe is AmazonUK.com or something like that, but you can find films that weren't released here that were released there. And I assume they do that because the films were popular over there and not here. This is another film that I'd seen originally on either HBO or Showtime when I was a lot younger. And I like the film. It's nothing to just jump up and down about, but I did like the film. It's a B film, and I've always wanted the film. Pretty expensive if you buy it in the U.S., so I got it, of course, in the U.K., brand new. And I think I paid, like, maybe $5 for it. Of course, what gets you there when you order from the U.K. is the shipping. And the film is Watchers. Still in the plastic. Glad to have it. And my goal is to get The Watchers Part 2 with Mark Singer. Okay. Next we have, I wanted to show you guys, or at least what I feel are goodbyes in motion pictures, you know, DVDs that feature three or more films that I really consider bargains. Now, the first one is a triple feature of films that I seen the original, never seen the second and third sequel. And of course, now there's been a remake that just flew over everybody's radar. Most people probably didn't even know they remade the first film in this series. But this is the It's Alive trilogy. All three films, I ordered this from Amazon, the It's Alive trilogy, directed by Larry Cohen. And here we have it, guys, It's Alive. And I think the last disc in the series is a dual layered one. But, now here's the remake, It's Alive Unrated, which I really heard some terrible things about, that this is just one of the most terrible films. like I said, I haven't seen it, but gonna give it a look. There we have. Bought it mostly for completion and just a little bit out of curiosity. Now, the last films are four packs of movies that I thought were good buys. And I kind of got them just to show them to you guys. Paper stuck on this one. But this is a four pack of films here. Pumpkinhead, Leprechaun, Wishmaster and Wishmaster 2. Now, of course, I bought this because they were all nice collected films on a few discs. But actually, I have all of these except Pumpkinhead 2. And when I get the first Pumpkinhead, I'll have the entire collection. But just to show you guys how it looks, the Pumpkinhead 2 DVD looks really, really nice. I wish they'd make more DVDs with original art on them. Then we have Leprechaun, which has nothing on it, and a dual layered for the last two films. I wish they would put art on these things, you know? Now, Target has been selling collections of films for quite a while now. They really got some good films on DVD in 4-packs, and I definitely suggest that you go up to Target and check them out, because sometimes you can get the entire series of films on a couple of discs. And the picture quality and all that is pretty good, and there's even, in some cases, special features. Now, I think these are some that I got. These two here are some that I got quite a while ago, but I don't think I've ever shown them. But just to give you an idea of what you can get on the, they call it the four film favorites. And this is a Nightmare on Elm Street one. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we have a second collection here. 5 and 6. And then we have, we have 5. And then we have Freddy's Dead, Wes Craven's New Nightmare, and Jason, or Freddy versus Jason. And you can't beat these guys. I mean, for, if you're new to a franchise and you just want to collect a certain franchise, these are definitely ones you should check out. Because, I mean, you can get the entire series. You know, I have the entire Nightmare on Elm Street films with the exception of the new one. And I'm not really interested in having the new one. Maybe one day. For $20. $20 for 8 films. It's the way to go. Now, this next set of films are movies that I've been wanting. And as a matter of fact, I might have a couple individually on 2 DVDs. But not really interested in buying the Blu-ray of the films, at least not yet. And some movies, you know, I don't want in Blu-ray. But when I saw these collected all together, 4 film favorites label, I had to get it. Now, this is all the Dirty Harry movies. I bought this for $9.99, 4 films, and I've got them all. I don't have to worry about going and buying this one, buying that one. They're all on this nice little 2-disc volume set, and it's done. It's over. The Dirty Harry films. I feel dirty for buying them. No, but yeah, I got them all. Don't have to worry about it. Next on the 4 film favorites label, we have The Matrix. The Matrix Reloaded and Matrix Revolutions, and then Animatrix. All on 2 discs collected in this one volume. And like I said, very nice to have. Very convenient. My collecting is over. Now, of course, I'll probably end up buying these films on Blu-ray in one set, but that's because, you know, these films with the digital effects and all just scream of put me on Blu-ray and buy me on Blu-ray. So I probably will buy these, but I'll still keep this collection because I think it's just a neat thing to have. And finally, guys, earlier I bought a 3-disc collection of the Hellraiser films, and I think it was the first 3 I bought in one set, and I've been wanting to buy the rest of the films in the series, and I heard they weren't really very good, they got progressively worse, but I've been wanting to buy them, and I saw this set here, which I believe may be all of the Hellraisers. And by the way, for you fans of Hellraiser, they are making a new film based upon the original film. But I don't expect a whole lot out of it. Now, this is Hellraiser 3. And then in this set, we have Hellraiser Bloodlines, Hellraiser Inferno, and Hellraiser Hellseeker. And like I said, there will be a Hellraiser festival coming up where I'll review all of the movies. Maybe something special for Halloween or perhaps even a B-Movie Mania special. But all the films, all collected, it's done. And I'm not even for sure if there's any more after this, could be. But definitely glad to have these in my collection. And what's kind of nice about all these films, even though some of you may not think that they're that good, is the fact that they kept them all rated R. You guys don't know how sick and tired I am of watching horror films with a PG-13 rating. I miss the good old days back in the 70s. Horror films from the 70s or 80s, early 80s, where they were all rated R. What the fuck would you have a horror film rated PG? Parental guidance. Well, hell, you don't want to bring the kids anyway. But I guess those days are done. But anyway, guys, that's my haul. And I'm sure there will be more. But, so goodbyes here, guys. And I'm going to go put these on my shelf, actually, and get her done. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good week. Take care.